Hello everyone, in this lecture we are going to study symmetrical simultaneous differential equations. First we are going to define them and then we are going to see how to obtain solution to these differential equations. Symmetrical simultaneous differential equations. These equations, they are of the type dx upon p equal to dy upon q equal to dz upon r, where this p, q, r, they are functions of x, y, z, or they may be constants also. So see, such equations, they are said to be symmetrical simultaneous differential equations. So what about the solution of such differential equations? So the solution of such differential equations contains or consists of mostly two independent relations of the type f1 of xyz equal to c1 and f2 of xyz equal to c2. So any two independent relations obtained from the given symmetrical simultaneous differential equation consists or constitute the solution of the given differential equation. So now we will see methods to find solution to this differential equation. So suppose the given differential equation is dx upon p equal to dy upon q equal to dz upon r. First method is method of combination or grouping. First of all, we will consider this first group, the first ratio and the second ratio. So that group we will consider here. So consider first group as dx upon p equal to dy upon q. Now what we are observing here, the differential variables are x and y, and therefore from these p and q, what we will do, we will try to eliminate z. If it cancel easily, then it is okay, otherwise we will try to eliminate it. Once we eliminate z from the given ratios, these ratios or this first group, then we left with terms only in x and y. Then this will be a differential equation of first order and first degree in x and y, which can be solved using the methods that we studied in the differential equations of first order and first degree. And then we will get the solution which is of the type, say, f1 of xyz equal to c1. Purposefully here I have kept this z. It is not necessary that all the variables should be there in the solution, and for that reason only here I have kept all the three variables. So this is one of the two relations, first relation. To get the second relation, we will consider the second group other than these two ratios. So let us consider the last two ratios as a second group. So that will give us dy upon q equal to dz upon r. Now here the differentiating variables are y and z. So therefore we have to eliminate x. So it may happen that x will get cancelled easily, or it can be eliminated easily. If both the things will not happen, then what we will do, we will use this first relation and then we will try to eliminate that x if possible. Okay, and suppose x got eliminated, then we left with terms in y and z only. So again it is the differential equation in y and z, which is of first order and first degree. Solving it, we will be getting the solution of the type f2 of xyz equal to c2. So this is the second relation. See, so this is the first relation and this one is the second relation. So both these relations together, they constitute the solution of this symmetrical simultaneous differential equation. So here we have considered as an example these two groups. Suppose the groups will not work, then we have to combine the ratios. We have to combine the ratios and then we have to equate it. And then after that, we have to find out the solution. Now let us go to second method. Second method is method of multipliers. So in this, what we are doing, we are choosing a set of multipliers. Here we will say that set is L1, M1 and N1, so that whatever the differential equation is given, so dx upon p equal to dy upon q equal to dz upon r, so we will combine these ratios as, which is equal to say L1 dx plus M1 dy plus N1 dz upon L1 p. So we have multiplied first ratio by L1, second by M1, the second multiplier, and third ratio by third multiplier. Then we have added all the three ratios and we have equated this. This is the property of the ratios. And we are going to choose these multipliers L1, M1 and N1 such that this denominator L1P plus M1Q plus N1R, this must be equal to 0. So once this denominator is 0, what does this implies? This implies the numerator is also equal to 0. So therefore L1 dx plus M1 dy plus N1 dz is also equal to 0. Once we get this, these L1, M1, N1, they are either constants or they are functions of x, y, z. But they are such functions so that this whatever term here we will be getting, it will be of the exact type. So whatever here differential we will be getting, it is the exact one, and hence we can obtain the solution easily. So general solution will be given like this, say f1 of xyz equal to c1. So this is one of the two relations. Now to get the second relation, what we are going to do? We are going to again choose the second set of multipliers, say L2, M2, N2. And we are going to follow the procedure same as like the previous one. But here the condition is that these L2, M2, N2, they should not be dependent of the first set of multipliers. Means, for example, if L1, M1, N1, they are 1, 1, 1, then L2, M2, N2 should not be 2, 2, 2, 3, 3, 3. Likewise, here I have considered the constant multipliers. Same thing is for the variable multipliers also. Means, if L1, M1, N1 is XYZ, then L2, M2, N2 should not be 2X, 2Y, 2Z. So they must be independent. So such set of multipliers we have to obtain. If we obtain such set of multipliers, then again we will follow the same method as like same procedure as like the previous one. So dx upon p equal to dy upon q equal to dz upon r. So we will multiply first ratio by L2, second by M2, both numerator and denominator, third ratio by N2, both numerator and denominator, and we will add all these three ratios. Again, we will be getting such term, and here also we are going to obtain or choose this set of multipliers in such a way that this denominator should be equal to 0. This implies that the numerator is equal to 0, which is of the type exact, and therefore the solution will be given as f2 of xyz equal to c2. So in this way we can obtain second relation in the solution of the symmetrical simultaneous differential equation. So this f1 and f2 together, they constitute solution of the given symmetrical simultaneous differential equation. Now here we are going to mention one thing, that suppose for few examples it may happen that the using only one method we will not be able to obtain the two relations. So in that case, what we are going to do, we are going to obtain the two relations using these two different methods. Means first relation by combination and grouping, and the second one by say method of multipliers. So that is also possible. So combinedly also we can use both the methods to get the two relations. But the important thing is that whatever the relations, two relations we are obtaining, they must be linearly independent. So that is the important condition. Now we will go to solve the examples. So consider the example, solve the differential equation dx upon y square z equal to dy upon x square z equal to dz upon y square x. Solution. Now you just observe these ratios. If I consider the first two ratios, then what we are observing? This zz, it is getting cancelled easily, and therefore we left with the terms in x and y only. So consider the first two ratios. So that z will get cancelled easily, we left with dx upon y square equal to dy upon x square. Do the cross multiplication, that will give us x square dx equal to y square dy, which is a differential equation of first order and first degree, and it is in variable separable form. So integrating it, we will be getting its solution as x cube upon 3 equal to y cube upon 3 plus integrating constant c, multiplying throughout by 3 and simplifying, we will be getting first relation as x cube minus y cube equal to c1. So that is the first relation. So see how simple is this. Second, for the second, now observe the ratios again. So clearly here I am observing that if I consider the first ratio and the third ratio, then this y square and y square is getting cancelled, and we left with the terms only in x and z. So to obtain the second relation, consider the second group as first ratio and the third ratio. So y square will get cancelled, and we left with dx upon z equal to dz upon x. Do the cross multiplication. Again, this is the differential equation of first order and first degree, which is in variable separable form. Integrate it and simplify. It will give us the solution as x square minus y square equal to c2. So see, we got the two relations which are independent, and these two relations together, they constitute solution of this differential equation, symmetrical simultaneous differential equation. See how simple this example is. Now we will consider one more example. Solve the differential equation x dx divided by z square minus 2yz minus y square is equal to dy upon y plus z equal to dz upon y minus z. Solution. Now you just observe these ratios. So here we are observing that in the second and third ratio, there is no x variable. Therefore, we will consider the first group as dy upon y plus z is equal to dz upon y minus z. Perform the cross multiplication, simplify the terms. So simplified form will be like this: z dy plus y dz minus y dy plus z dz equal to 0. So purposefully I have combined these two terms, because from this we can write the expression as d of yz. So this z dy plus y dz, it is the differential of yz. Okay, and then minus y dy plus z dz equal to 0. So this is the exact differential, and therefore we can integrate it directly with respect to the respective variables. So that will give us integrating. So integration of 1 with respect to yz is yz minus integration of y with respect to y is y square upon 2 plus integration of z with respect to z is z square upon 2 equal to integrating constant. Now multiply throughout by 2, that will give us 2yz minus y square plus z square equal to 2c is equal to c1 we have considered. So this is the first relation in the solution. Now we will go for obtaining the second relation, but if you observe here, now it is not possible to consider the any other two ratios as a second group from other than second and third. So here what we are going to do, we are going to identify multipliers so that the denominators will be equal to zero. Now you just try this. If we consider the set of multipliers as 1yz, so multiply first ratio, numerator and denominator, by 1, second numerator, second ratio, in the numerator multiply numerator by y, denominator by y, and in the third ratio multiply numerator by z and denominator by z. Then perform the multiplication in denominator and see whether the addition is 0 or not. If it is 0, then our set of multipliers is correct. So here it is correct. So we'll go to that set again. So now we will choose the set of multipliers, say 1yz, so that we will be getting this expression x dx upon z square minus 2yz minus y square is equal to dy upon y plus z equal to dz upon y minus z equal to. Now see here, first ratio in the numerator and denominator we multiplied it by 1, second both numerator denominator by y, third numerator and denominator by z, and we added all the three ratios and we equated them to the new ratio x dx plus y dy plus z dz divided by z square minus 2yz minus y square plus y square plus yz minus z square. Now clearly here we are observing that the denominator is equal to 0. So as denominator is 0, so obviously numerator we can equate it to 0. So see here we got the numerator as x dx plus y dy plus z dz which is equal to 0, which is exact 1, and therefore the solution is obtained directly integrating this relation. So the solution is x square by 2 plus y square by 2 plus z square by 2 equal to c, and if we multiply throughout by 2, that will give us x square plus y square plus z square equal to 2c, which we can replace by c2. So that is the second relation, and hence the relation 1 and relation 2 together they constitute solution of the given symmetrical simultaneous differential equation. So see how simple these examples are to solve. I hope you have understood this. Thanks for watching this video.